everyone, welcome to One and All Kids. We are having our party because Jesus loves everyone. Today is all about how we, you and me, can love other people who are a little bit different than you and me. Sometimes we can feel different, but Jesus still loves us, you and me. We can love others in the same way. So let's jump into the party. Let's go.
Hey guys, we're back to doing our special song called I've Got the Joy, Joy, Joy Down in My Heart. Let's do it. I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart. I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart.
Where?
Down in my heart to stay. And I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart. Yes, I'm so happy, so very happy. I've got the love of Jesus in my heart. Bye. See you later, guys.
Get on up, everyone. It is time to worship. We get to sing, we get to dance and praise because Jesus is incredible. Let's start our praise party with one of my favorite songs. It's called Rooftops.
There is a fire in my heart, to tell the world just who you are, in everything I do, in everything I say, I will never be ashamed, cause I just wanna let go, Jesus you have saved me so, I will never be ashamed, I will sing from the rooftops. With all that I have, I'm gonna lift up both of my hands, I'm gonna make it loud, gonna sing and shout from the rooftops. Oh, you are my God. Oh, you are my God. Oh. So with this fire in my heart I'll tell the world just who you are and everything I do, and everything I say, I will never be afraid
from the rooftops, with all that I have, I'm gonna lift up both of my hands, I'm gonna make it loud, gonna sing and shout from the rooftop. Oh, you are my God. Oh, you are my God. Oh,
you'll never stop loving us, you'll never stop, no. You'll never stop loving us, you'll never stop, no. You'll never stop loving us, you'll never stop, no. You'll never stop loving us, you'll never stop, no. From the rooftops, with all that I have, I'm gonna lift up both of my hands, I'm gonna make it loud, gonna sing and shout from the rooftops. Oh, you are my God,
you are my God.
That was incredible. Let's keep on singing and praising God with another song called Love the Way.
Up in the morning and I wiggle my toes.
Oh,
I stretch out my arms and I'm scratching my nose.
Praising Jesus brings me so much joy. We get to sing another song at the end of service, but for now, let's grab our Bible, grab a seat, and get ready to learn with us.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hello, everyone. I'm Pastor Julianne, and today we are here with our friend, Albert.
Hello, friends. I'm so excited to be here with everyone.
We are still having a party for our week 2 of our series, and we get to do something really special today.
What is it?
Today, we get to write a piece of love mail.
Wow. Why does it have to be love mail? Can't it be regular mail or stinky mail or glitter mail?
It's love mail because we are learning about how Jesus loves everyone. Do you want to write your own piece of love mail?
Maybe
to one of your friends?
Of course I do. I want to be like Jesus and love everyone too.
Sounds good. While Albert writes his love mail, let's all call up Ollie to see what our true Bible story is all about. Ready?
Wait. I want to call out Ollie and hear our story too. Then I'll finish my love mail.
Okay, Albert and friends, here we go. Let's yell Ollie on the count of 3. Ready?
One, two, three, Ollie!
Just follow me through. Ooh, ooh.
Follow me through. Ollie's got a Bible story for me and you.
Hola, friends. I'm Luis, the handyman. I'm just fixing this bubble machine for my friends in the clubhouse. They need it for a party they're having. I've got my invitation right here. We're all invited to the party. Hey, that reminds me of today's story. Do you want to help me build it? Great, let's put it on the story fence. Hammers up, little builders. Ready? Uno, dos, tres, hammer. Great job, little helpers. You can put your hammers down. Now, we just need our story tools. Yep, we have everything we need. Today's true story from the Bible starts with a well. A long time ago, people would go to a well to get water. They didn't have sinks or refrigerators or water bottles. If someone was thirsty, they had to go to a well for water. And guess who was thirsty? Jesus. He had been walking a long way and was tired, so he sat down at a well. A woman came to the well to get water while Jesus was sitting there. The woman looked at Jesus and knew that they were from different towns. Jesus asked the woman, "Will you give me a drink?" The woman was surprised that Jesus asked her for water because she knew people from her town were not friends with people from his town. So she said, "Why are you asking me for a drink?" But do you think that where she was from mattered to Jesus? No, of course not. No matter where you live, Jesus wants to be your friend and loves you very much. Now, let's pretend that Jesus is having a party. Who is invited to Jesus' party? Do you think people who live where it's really, really cold are invited to Jesus' party? Yes! What about people who live where it's really, really hot? Are they invited to Jesus' party? Yes! What about people who live in very tall buildings? Are they invited to Jesus's party? Yes! What about people who live in small buildings? Are they invited to Jesus's party? Yes! No matter where you live, Jesus wants to be your friend, and Jesus loves you. Everyone is invited to Jesus's party. Jesus loves everyone. Hey there, Ollie. Tell me, who does Jesus love?
Jesus loves everyone. Yes, it's true. Now, let's hear it from you. Tell me, who does Jesus love?
Jesus loves everyone. That's the truth, friends. You better believe it. Adios!
Who does Jesus love?
Jesus loves everyone.
Look, I finished my love mail.
That looks so good. But do you remember our story that Ollie told us from the Bible?
Of course I do. There was Jesus and some other people and probably some dirt. Maybe some people laughed. Oh no, I don't remember our story.
Lucky for us, we have some amazing friends who can help us out. Friends, can you help Albert remember our story from today? When he asks a question, just shout out the answer.
I think our story started with water, but I can't remember where they got it from. Did people get water from the Dasani water factory in bottles? Or did they get it from a well?
Let's hear it, friends. Shout out your answers. It's a well. Good job. Okay, what's next, Otis? I mean, Otis, so funny. Albert, of course.
Why would you do that?
I think it's the orange on your nose. It kind of throws me off sometimes.
Oh, yeah, we're super similar looking, though, yeah. So I get that. Okay, sure. Yeah, okay, just for reference, I'm Albert.
Yes, you are Albert.
Say it.
You are Albert.
Okay, cool. Thanks, Pastor Julianne. Well, I know someone was thirsty, but I don't remember who wanted a drink. Was it a giant pink elephant or was it Jesus?
Let's hear it. It was Jesus. Right again. Last one, Albert.
Good job. Jesus met a lady, but I think she was different in some way. Did she have glowing blue hair or was she just from a different place than Jesus?
Let's see. She was from a different place than Jesus. But did that matter to Jesus?
No! Jesus asked her for a drink because he loves everyone. Thanks for helping me remember our story, friends.
You are all so good at remembering our story. And another thing I love to remember is our memory verse. It is from 1 Corinthians 16:14. Say it with us. Ready? 1, 2, 3.
Do everything in love. 1 Corinthians 16:14.
That was awesome. But can we all say it like we're underwater now?
Sure, that sounds fun. Is that because we were talking about water from a well?
Yep, let's do it. Friends, say the memory verse with us like we are under water.
Ready? One, two, three. Wow, it's like we just went swimming. That was so fun.
Yeah, I can't even swim, so I don't even know how I did that, but that was awesome.
Now it's time for us to pause, take a deep breath, and see how we can love everyone, just like Jesus. Think about a time when you saw someone different than you. Maybe they had a different hair or skin color. Maybe they dressed differently or just talked differently than you. Just like Jesus loved the woman at the well, we can love everyone, even if they're different from us. Tell the person or the people next to you how you can love everyone around you. Like this.
Ooh. I can love everyone by writing them love mail.
That's a good one. I think I'll share what I have with everyone to show them love. Because why wouldn't I want to share my stuff with everyone? Now, all of you try. Talk about how you can love others like Jesus. All of you can love everyone just like Jesus. Good job. Now, let's take some time to pray. When we pray, we are talking to God. We can share everything with Him, and we can listen to what He tells us. So let's all close our eyes and talk with God. God, thank you for sending Jesus to love the woman at the well, just like you love everyone. Please help us to love everyone around us just like you. We ask for your help. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Bye, friends.
See you next time.
Wow, I love that Jesus invites everyone to His party, even if we feel a little bit different. Remember that everyone is invited because Jesus loves everyone. Invite your friends to our party at church so that we can all learn about Jesus together. I am so thankful that Jesus loves me, even though I may feel a little different sometimes. One way that I want to say thank you to Jesus is by giving my offering. Jesus loves me and He gives me everything that I have. And if I have like 10 confetti pieces, I would want to give Jesus my very best piece. And we can do the same thing with our offering money. You can talk to your parents or your leaders about giving your offering today. And now it's time to worship by singing and dancing. So let's get up on our feet and let's sing our next song together. It's called Really Awesome Plan.
He's got a plan. He's got a.
Yes, he does.
He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know. That's what I know. That's what I know. That's what I know.
Let's go.
I know that I can trust Him.
Yeah.
I know that I can trust Him.
Yeah.
No matter what the season.
Yeah.
His plans are for a reason.
Yeah.
I know they are good. I know they are blessed. The reason I know is because He said He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know.
Oh, that's what I know.
That's what I know.
Oh, that's what I know.
And when I'm feeling so sad,
yeah, yeah.
Hey, when I am afraid,
yeah, yeah.
God will never leave me.
Yeah.
No, 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 His love will never change.
Yeah.
I know they are good. I know they are blessed. The reason I know is because I said He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a plan for me. He's got a really, really, really awesome plan for me. That's what I know.
Oh, that's what I know.
That's what I know.
Oh, that's what I know.
Awesome job, everyone. I love worshiping with you and learning with you. Don't forget to invite your friends to come to church with you for our party.
Woo, let's party.
Until then, I want to send you off into the week with one hope and one life in Christ. Bye, friends.